land-grant universities, and extension, putting knowledge to work. Every college and university teaches classes. Many universities are also research institutions, pursuing basic and applied research. Some universities have an incredibly important third mission, to take this research-based knowledge and bring it directly to communities, families, consumers, and business owners. This is the mission of Extension. But how did it come about? And why is Extension only at some universities? In the early 1800s, colleges and universities were mostly private and taught law, medicine, and theology. And they were only available to a small part of our citizenry. At the time of the Civil War, 75% of U.S. citizens lived on farms. So the country needed agricultural and practical education. And it also needed to increase agricultural proficiency to free people on farms to do other kinds of work. There wasn't much money, but there was a lot of land. In 1862, President Lincoln signed the first Morrill Act, which granted 30,000 acres of that land to each eligible state for an institution to teach agricultural and mechanic arts. Later, land-grant status was extended to other universities, such as historically black colleges and universities in 1890, and 34 colleges serving Native Americans in 1994. Today, there are more than 100 land-grant institutions, which reflect the importance of education in our country. Land-grant universities were different from previous schools. University education was now open to a broader range of students who could also learn the applied sciences. Agricultural research extended beyond the lab with the Hatch Act of 1887, which funded agricultural research stations at land grants, so that research could be also applied where production happens. But one more important link was needed to take the knowledge developed at universities to impact the everyday lives of Americans. In 1914, the Cooperative Extension Service was created as a non-formal education system. The Extension Service expands learning beyond the college classroom. Extension agents and specialists take information and new technologies to each community. Early programs were delivered in fields, barns, and even on the backs of trains. Today's Extension continually adapts to meet evolving challenges. Our modern Extension Service addresses a wide variety of content from economic development, family and youth, to health. Extension agents administer the 4-H program, the nation's largest youth program, which builds skills and leadership in kids ages 8 to 18. Across all programs, Extension is community-based, reflecting local and changing needs. For example, if local farmers find a new pest is damaging their crops, agents raise that problem to specialists, who then investigate the best solutions. Agents then share that research back with the farmers. In health outreach, agents deliver research-based programs to improve issues such as mental health, diabetes education, or nutrition, and they focus on the best approaches for each community. The three missions of instruction, research, and extension at land-grant universities make them special. Our extension agents and specialists see the incredible impact they have on communities, and they believe strongly in the mission of extension. And because New Mexico State University is the state's largest land-grant institution, we are in every county, serving every community. Every New Mexican is a part of NMSU, and Extension serves every New Mexican by putting knowledge to work.